Loss of a loved one, loss of a job, divorce, sickness, wayward child. What do you do whenever the bottom completely drops out of your life? What do you do whenever the dreams that you had for your life suddenly turn into nightmares? In the Bible, there's a man named Job who lost everything. He lost his 10 children. He lost his health. He lost his wealth. He lost everything that was near and dear to his heart. As a matter of fact, in his diary, he even says the very thing that he feared the most has come upon him. The very thing that he dreaded has happened to him. What do you do in those times in your life where you have completely given up hope and you can't seem to figure out what God is doing in your life? I believe that if Job were here today, that he would share 7 things with us about what to do whenever our dreams turn into nightmares. The first thing that he would tell us is that being a good person does not exempt you from trouble. In Job's diary, it says that he was a good man. He was a blameless man. He was an upright man. As a matter of fact, it says that there was no one like Job in the entire earth. It also says elsewhere in his diary that just as sure as sparks fly upward, man is born to trouble. I believe Job would remind us that, you know what, you can do everything right in your life. You can go to church. You can be obedient. You can be the best husband, the best wife, the best parent. You can eat healthy for the rest of your life, and that still does not exempt you from trouble hitting your home. I believe the second thing that Job would remind us today is that God is big enough to handle our grief. Several times in Job's diary, we see that he's crying out to God. He's frustrated. He's confused. He's angry. He's disappointed in God. At times, he even wonders why he was even born and why the nurse allowed him to live. And what we see is that even though Job is trying to reconcile how God can be a good God in the midst of the difficulties and the bad things that were happening to him, God never left his side. The third thing that I believe that Job would tell us if he was sitting here today is that we should never get too attached to earthly things. He says in his diary, "Naked I came from the womb, and naked I will return. The Lord gives and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord." You see, Job will remind us today that everything that we have is on loan from God. We don't own anything. We are merely stewards. We are merely managers of the things that he has entrusted to us. We are managers of our children. We are managers of our wealth. We are managers of everything that he has entrusted to us. So as painful as it sounds, if God were to decide to take something near and dear and precious away from us, because it was never ours in the first place and we were merely stewards over it, he has the right to do so. The fourth thing that I believe that Job would tell us today is that we should not go through life, trials, difficulties, and our deepest pains without community. In his diary, it says that when he was at the lowest point of his life, when the bottom dropped out of his life and everything that he ever dreamed of was taken away from him, it says that he had friends that came and sat with him for 7 days, and because they saw that his grief was so great, they did not speak a word. My friends, if you want to have people in your life during the lowest point, the lowest season of your life, when the bottom completely drops out and you want to give up hope and you want to just throw in the towel and give up on life, it starts by you now investing in those relationships now so that whenever the difficulties come in your life, those people, those true friends, will emerge and show themselves strong in your life, and they will be there with you in the midst of life's greatest challenges. The fifth thing that I believe that Job would tell us if he were sitting here today is that oftentimes the trials that we go through in our lives are tests of our faith. He says in his diary, as he was frustrated because he was trying to figure out what God was up to and he was looking for God in every way, in every place, he says, "I go east, but he's not there. I go west, but I cannot find him. I do not see him in the north, for he is hidden. I look to the south, but he is concealed." Now watch this. He says here in his diary, "But he knows where I am going." In other words, God, even though I cannot see you, I know that you can see me and you can see every step and everything that I'm doing. And he says, "And when he tests me, I will come out as pure as gold." So he says, "God, I recognize that the trial that I'm going through in my life is nothing more than a test. But God, I resolve not to go backwards, but to go forwards. And whenever you test me, God, I am going to come out on the other side as pure gold." He also says here, "For I have stayed on God's paths. I have followed his ways and not turned aside. I have not departed from his commands, but I have treasured his words more than my daily food. And so Job reminds us today that no matter what you're going through, it is a test from God not to destroy you, but to develop your faith. The sixth thing that I believe Job would tell us today is that we may not ever get the reason behind why he's allowing the things that are going on in your life. You know, in the first part of his diary, he says that, you know what, God was up to something behind the scenes that he had no idea about. And so oftentimes we're frustrated and we're trying to figure out, God, why is this happening to me? And we're stressed out. And for 38 chapters in his diary, Job was seeking God and he was questioning God. He was frustrated and he was complaining to God because he was could not understand why these things were happening to him. And guess what? He never got the answer to why God allowed these terrible things to happen in his life. And my friends, you may be here today and you're wondering, why did my spouse leave me? Why did my children have to be born this way? Why did God leave me without a job for so long? Why is it that my children were wayward even though I raised them in with godly principles? And you know what? God may not ever give you the reason behind the pain that you're dealing with. The seventh and final thing that I believe Job would tell us today is that God always writes the final chapter in our lives. You see, in chapter 42 of Job's diary, it says that God not only restored to him everything that he lost, but also gave him more in the end. You see, even though we can't see it at times and we can't figure out what God is up to, oftentimes there is a purpose behind our pain, and oftentimes God is working things out in our lives behind the scenes that we have absolutely no idea about. And all along, when we think that God is against us, God is oftentimes behind the scenes setting things up to bless us on the other side. So my friends, I don't know what you may be dealing with at this point in your life, but Job reminds us that even when he was at his lowest point, he said, God, though you slay me, yet will I trust you. Don't give up on God and lean on and rely on the community that God has given you. And remember that whatever trial you're going through right now is simply a test to develop your faith.